Three new features were introduced in a recent update to Snapseed from Google. In this tutorial, I'm going to cover the new Expand tool, which I think is the most universally useful of these exciting new features. With the Expand tool, we can create more space around the edges of our image. I'm going to demonstrate with this photo that I captured on a cold winter morning in Yellowstone National Park. Now, I've already tuned up this image to get ready for this lesson, and I'm happy with the colors and everything else. Before we jump to the Expand tool, let me show you that right now, this image matches the dimensions that my cell phone natively captures. I'm going to open up the Crop tool to show you what I mean. Since this photo is from a Samsung Galaxy phone, it was captured with the 16:9 aspect ratio. If I tap back and forth here between the original and the 16:9 aspect ratio buttons, then you'll see that nothing changes. I could easily change the crop in here to some other ratio, but I like where everything is positioned right now within my original frame. Any type of new crop that I might set would cut into the image and thus reduce the size of my photo. As we crop in tighter, we are reducing the number of pixels on our image. And in this case, that's the opposite of what I really want to do. What I want to do here is to add more pixels up there in the sky above that mountain than I actually capture. So I'm going to tap on the little X here to cancel out of the crop tool. Now I'll bring up the new Expand tool and show you something amazing. When the Expand tool loads, I'm going to set the fill mode to smart. And now I'm going to drag with one finger along the top edge of my photo. As I drag, Snapseed will begin to create new pixels for me along this edge. That's amazing. For what it's worth, we have seen something similar in this app when working with the healing tool and with the perspective tool, but this is the first time where we've been able to use this smart fill magic to actually create an image that is larger than what we actually captured. If I keep pushing this top edge up, then the pattern that Snapseed creates in the clouds will eventually become a little repetitive. I'll show you how to clean this up with the healing tool in just a second, but before I do, I need to be honest. The Expand tool in smart mode here needs to invent new pixels for you. Snapseed will do its best to create a plug of new pixels that blends seamlessly with the edge of your original image. But if you pick a photo with a really complicated pattern around the edge, then the results might not be as impressive. This tool does its best work with things like the sky, where the pattern that it creates doesn't need to be too precise. Here, though, I think that Snapseed has done a good job, so I'm going to tap on the check mark to commit this change. To clean things up now, I'm going to launch the healing tool, and then I'm going to swipe a few times over the parts of the image that appear unnatural or too repetitive. If you make a mistake, don't forget about the undo button down there on the toolbar. Things look great to me here, so I'm going to commit these changes. And now, I'm going to save my work. Now that our expanded image has been saved, let me show you another great use for the new Expand tool. In a previous tutorial, I talked about how the frames that Snapseed creates always overlay part of our underlying image. Let me pick something simple here, like frame style number one, which just adds a white border. And then I'm going to swipe my finger to the right to increase the frame width. See how that big white frame comes in from the edges and how eventually it would begin to cover over a significant portion of my photo? Well, now with the super cool Expand filter, we can do even better. I'll cancel out of here with the X button, and then I'll go back into Expand. This time, though, I'm going to set the fill mode to black. Instead of just pushing out one edge like I did last time with the sky, this time, I'm going to press my thumb and forefinger against the screen at the same time. And then I'm going to use that push out move to expand in every direction. By using both fingers at the same time, I can create this nice even black border that is completely outside the boundaries of my original image. This is so cool because for the first time, we can create a framing effect without sacrificing any part of our original image. I'll tap the check mark to commit this change. I might be getting carried away here, but I'm going to launch the expand tool yet again. And now I'm going to switch the fill mode to white. Again, I'll use the two-finger push-out move so that once I commit my work, we have a nice, elegant, double border style effect. I'm going to tap down here in the empty space near the bottom to hide all of Snapseed's interface away. To finish things off, I'll press and hold one finger against the screen a few times to show you the complete before and after. From this to this. If you ask me, we have made a bigger, better image here, and I really like the double border effect that we can create in no time thanks to the expand tool. If you've been playing along, and if you like what you've created at this point, then don't forget to save your work.